Let's see how to pre-process a dataset for translation. This is a task of, well, translating a sentence in another language. This video will focus on how to pre-process your dataset once you've managed to put it in the following format. One column for the input text and one for the target text. Here is how we can achieve this with the datasets library on the KDE4 dataset for English to French translation. As long as you manage to have your data look like this, you should be able to follow the same steps. For once, our labels are not integers, corresponding to some classes, but plain text. We'll thus need to tokenize them like our inputs. There is a trap there, though, as if you tokenize your targets like your inputs, you'll hit a problem. Even if you don't speak French, you might notice some weird things in the tokenization of the targets. Most of the words are tokenized in several subtokens, while fish, one of the only English words, is tokenized as a single word. That's because our inputs have been tokenized as English. Since our model knows two languages, you have to warn it when tokenizing the targets, so it switches in French mode. This is done with the AsTargetTokenizerContextManager. You can see it results in a more compact tokenization. Processing the whole dataset is then super easy with the map function. You can pick different maximum lengths for the inputs and targets, and choose to pad at this stage to that maximum length by setting padding equal max length. Here, we'll show you how to pad dynamically as it requires one more step. Your inputs and targets are all sentences of various lengths. We'll pad the inputs and targets separately, as the maximum lengths of the inputs and targets might be different. Then we pad the inputs with the pad token and the target with the -100 index to make sure they are not taken into account in the loss computation. Once this is done, batching inputs and targets becomes super easy. The Transformers library provides us with a data collector to do this all automatically. You can then pass it to the trainer with your datasets, or use it in the 2TF dataset method before using model.fit on your Keras model.